Line between real life and a virtual one is getting blurrier. Last night, we told you how Orlando is becoming the center of the metaverse.
Well, tonight, I'm taking you inside the metaverse with your first look at Orlando's digital twin.
This room may not look like much now, but soon it will be home to Orlando's digital twin.
Not only is it going to be a 180-degree LED wall, but in the middle will be a holographic image.
800 square miles coast to coast of Central Florida will come to life. Some of that will be in resolution so high you can zoom in and see the traffic lines on the roads.
This is taking the very physical world that we all live in and digitizing it and putting it into a virtual world.
That world will be on display at the new Orlando Economic Partnership headquarters in Orlando, which dreamed up this whole idea.
And then having a holographic table that projects up, you're putting the two together to create what we call an immersive experience. Interesting.
It was all built here in the City Beautiful. John Cunningham with the software developer Unity says it will provide an unbelievably real look at Central Florida with data updating in real time.
And I thought this would be a really interesting project for us to get involved with, to showcase our technology and how it can be used outside of gaming in real world applications.
You might be thinking, so what can this digital twin really do? OEP President Tim Giuliani says the possibilities are endless. In phase one, it will help market Orlando.
So imagine you're charged with the responsibility of an expansion of a company, and you bring a group of executives and you're touring 3 to 5 cities. You arrive in Orlando, you've got 24 hours to understand the market and decide if this is a city that's going to win that sort of competition.
The digital twin will eliminate time-consuming site visits and provide data on transportation, utilities, even the talent pool of workers. The OEP can even bring the twin on the road through VR headsets, showing executives what it would be like to live and work here without ever leaving their office.
They're used to a 75-point PowerPoint deck, and all of a sudden, they're standing in a virtual world. And it's just going to be a wow factor.
Developers say the digital twin can also help utility companies plan for expansion or map out new transit routes to connect Central Floridians to more job opportunities. It could even help us prepare for disasters and the impacts of climate change.
The more data we get into this digital twin, the richer it becomes, the more usable it becomes.
This technology has actually been around for decades, but it's never been used for anything like this.
This will be the first in the world digital twin at this scale.
The fact that Orlando is at the forefront of this kind of technology might come as a surprise, but Cunningham says it shouldn't.
A lot of people don't know that Orlando is the hub of modeling and simulation globally. More than $6 billion are spent here by the U.S. Department of Defense alone. So this really is an important ecosystem for the development of these types of applications.
Orlando's digital twin is part of the metaverse. It will essentially be living, constantly updating and growing. And eventually, you might be able to access the digital twin right from your cell phone or AR glasses to tour real estate, check the traffic, or who knows?
And the Orlando Economic Partnership says it's invested $1 million into phase one of the digital twin, which is on track to be up and running by the end of the summer. And then in phase two, community partners will pay to input their data. They are hoping to see that start to happen by the end of the year.